What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome back to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you're all doing well this evening. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. Co-hosting with me tonight, the one, the only, the asset, James Gale. James, how are you?
I'm doing well. My mic is unmuted, made sure that it is. Busy day, wonderful day, opening day. Happy opening day to you, Rob.
And to you as well. Well, with that kind of intro, how about without further ado, let's just dive right into our opening day themed poll question. One of the things I look forward to every year is Darren Revelle's tweets about all the different types of food that
I've got one in the. I've got on the tab right here. We'll talk about it.
And so that got me thinking, you know, buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack, and obviously hot dogs are a staple. So the poll question tonight is, James, if you would do the honors.
Happy MLB opening day. What is your must-have ballpark food when you go to a game? Peanuts. They are in last place right now at 8.6%. Cracker Jack popcorn, 13.8%. Hot dog leading the way, 65.5%. And then local favorite, which is a wonderful option. I'm glad you included it there, in third place at 12.1% with 58 votes. I voted hot dog. I think it's a fun treat to have at the ballpark that I don't normally have that often at home. And so when I go to the ballpark, you get the hot dog. And that kind of ties into local favorite. I lived in Milwaukee for 10 years. You could go there and get a brat with grilled onions and sauerkraut. If you go to Cleveland, I remember going to Indians games and you get that stadium mustard that they have. That's just so dang good. Dodger dogs have their own toppings here. They usually just have the regular old relish and mustard and onions, but it's still really tasty. So that's why I picked hot dog. What did you pick?
I picked local favorites. I'm wondering, Matt Balsley, are you a Chicago guy? Are you a Chicago guy? Because I went with your choice. Give me a Polish with grilled onions.
Yep, there it is.
Some of that mustard. I love that. If you haven't already done so, go ahead and retweet that vote. We'll update that. But we had some really good comments. So, you know, let's see. Well, Ryan Schooling, I don't know what stadium you're going to. Beluga caviar on toast points, pheasant under glass, and ice cold Dom Perignon, of course. Good one.
Yeah, wow.
Chris Stuber, cheesesteak. Philly, of course, right, buddy? So he picked local fare.
He said without, which means without onions?
Right? I guess.
I think so. I can't remember. He explained it to me at the National when we were in Atlantic City, because there was a good cheesesteak place there. And he explained it, but I already forget. I think it means without onions. Somebody in the chat can tell us.
Stuffed Miami said nachos in a batting helmet. Melanie Paul said nachos in a plastic helmet. Oh, and ice cream. And David B. even said nachos. And the first one that got nachos going, Stephen Radford, says, I picked hot dog, but nachos are a big favorite of mine. So, yeah, only four choices. And maybe
now, Chris Brown, he said, look up the milkshake sundae out of the White Sox are offering. I have that on Darren Revelle's tweet.
Insane, right? Yeah. Look at that.
Makes my teeth hurt. It makes my stomach hurt just looking at it. I would still try and take a bite.
The one tweet that he showed that got me going was the dessert chimichanga out at the D-backs game. That thing looked absolutely phenomenal. It was like this apple pie type a la mode thing. Oh, so yeah, that I'm with you. That milkshake. There it is. That right there. Read that. Would you read that?
Crispy tortilla loaded with apple pie filling and topped with vanilla frozen yogurt, caramel sauce, whipped cream, Cracker Jack, and strawberries.
Ooh, yes!
Cracker Jacks. Wow. That's wild.
Oh, man. Yeah, that was like, drooling like Homer.
Right?
All right. Well, okay. We better shift topics before I get too hungry and want to go take a break and get something to eat. All right. So like I said, please do weigh in on that. We want to up that sample size. It is opening day, so let's see what we can get up that up to before the end of the show, if you will. And again, be sure to retweet that. All right, James, we do have several things to talk about in this week's Hobby Happening segment. Going to help me with this, but I'll kick off. Here's a look at this week's Hobby Happenings. First up, it's that time of year again. Topps announced that its popular Topps Truck Tour is returning for the 2024 season. And unlike previous years where they've hit just a handful, they're going to be hitting every MLB stadium this year. Stay tuned for updates on when the truck will be at your ballpark by following them on X at Topps.
Wow, that's impressive. Sports Collector Daily reports that PSA has increased the price of its Collectors Club membership from $99 to $149. In addition to the Loop credit, PSA has partnered with Fanatics Live to offer credit on the Breaking platform for members as a giveback. Standard members will get a $60 Fanatics Live credit, while premium members will get a $125 credit. PSA also says it will offer members-only card breaks with Fanatics Live, exclusive promo cards, and other perks in addition to their subscriptions to PSA's magazine. As always, club membership comes with discounts on authentication grading, including monthly specials and bulk grading.
Yeah, and you still get the like $100 loop credit. So that's like, I mean,
pretty decent.
The two benefits like pay for the fee in and of itself. That's pretty cool. All right. Well, this is a public service announcement. Be very, very wary of doing this with your cards and be aware of the possibilities even after being slapped. What am I talking about? Well, there are several products on the market that advertise themselves as card care and card cleaning solutions. So do stains cleaned with such items return over time after being treated with such solutions? Well, they most definitely can, as evidenced by these images posted on X by Tiffany Cards. You can see the before and after. He even posted a video on YouTube showing why all card cleaning kits don't even list their ingredients and won't back up their products with a guarantee. They're really just a temporary masking of the problem that will eventually return.
Yikes. Formula One has announced a multi-year renewal of its trading card and sticker partnership with Topps. The move means Fanatics-owned Topps will continue as the official licensee for the popular global racing series, having first acquired the rights to F1 in 2020. As a result, Topps will continue to produce trading cards and stickers featuring drivers on the F1, F2, and F3 circuits. SC Daily reports that as a part of the deal, Topps will attend multiple Grand Prix events across the 2024 FIA Formula One World Championship schedule, beginning at the Austin Grand Prix in late June. Formula One says exclusive cards will be offered on site.
Awesome. Okay, well, let's talk or let's take a look at some recent trading card market insights from the collectibles guru, shall we? First, how's this for a well-timed and epic pull? This year's Bowman Chrome Caitlin Clark Gold Vinyl 101 Auto was pulled at Nash Cards in Memphis from the last box on the shelf.
Love that.
Yep. Next up, the 2023 Bowman U Chrome Superfractor LeBron and Bronny James dual autograph one of one sold for $114,000. Begging the question, is that higher or lower than you expected? Sound off in the comments if you would. Pretty interesting though. Okay, now this next one, definite dope. One of the best Mike Trout cards in existence sold for a massive loss this week. It was the most recently purchased in October 2021 for $1,080,000. It sold on March 23rd for just $216,000. So over the whole time of 1.5 years, that's a net loss of $864,000 or 80%, leading me to believe that someone needed a tax write-off. Had to, right? Ouch. And lastly, file this under epically ridiculous. Not necessarily card related, but remember that scene in Titanic where Rose is floating on that piece of furniture or whatever, and Jack freezes to death and dies? Yeah, of course we do. Well, you aren't going to believe this, James, but that famous piece of wood paneling from the ending of the Titanic film sold at auction this past weekend for, get ready for this, $718,750. Dollars. How's that for crazy?
That's wild.
Next up, one of our favorite products in the hobby is scheduled to release in May, and Leaf has been teasing out some of the signers over the last several weeks. But this post on X absolutely floored even us. It is not in any way common to see a current film star of the magnitude of one Margot Robbie sign autographs for money, because frankly, stars like her usually just don't need it and or care, which makes Leaf securing her as a signer in the upcoming pop century absolutely epic. Big congratulations, Leaf.
Yeah, wow.
And we aren't exactly sure what this is all about yet, but Darren Revell posted this on X saying, every week, millions of dollars is spent on collectibles and memorabilia, yet there hasn't been a real media outlet to cover this asset class. That ends April 8th. For collectors, by collectors. Invest in yourself in collect media. Well, I don't know, Darren. We've been hosting this media outlet since 2016, so I don't know. Anyway.
He's a little troll, isn't he? Sometimes. Cryptozoic Entertainment's new CZ Plus brand is going metal with the pending release of Dark Knight's Metal. This week, an initial artist signers list was announced and features such heavyweights as Jim Lee, Greg Capullo, and John Romita Jr. Almost said senior. Stay tuned for more details as they become available, and be sure to check out the product preview on GoJTS.net.
Some pretty big names. Before Breaker's online streaming platforms, eBay, and other auction sites, outside of visiting your LCS, there was seriously only one other way to buy sports cards.
You buy this for $39.99, guess what, folks? You take the L away. You put a W there, baby. You're a winner, man. You're the real deal. You're picking up chicks. Let me tell you something. You buy this set at $39.99, baby, you're the cock of the walk, man. You walk into the bar and you just find the hottest chick and you go, you, me, guess what? She says, why would I go out with you? Because I bought the deal on Wild West Deals for $39.99, that's why. She says, can I go home with you? That's how simple it is. That's how it works. That's what this set brings to the table. Because you know what she sees? She sees a man who knows what he wants. She sees a man who says, good deals don't get by me, baby. I move. I act. I act quick. I act now. I go to wildwestdeals.com. Boom. That's why you're hanging with chicks all night long. That's why you got guys like Michael Jordan calling you wanting to hang out with you, baby. Because you bought it for $39.99. Is that crazy? That's the way it works around here. This deal will change your life. Don't look at yourself in the mirror and be disgusted tomorrow. Don't look at yourself in the mirror and go, what's wrong with me? What is wrong with me? Why am I this way?
That's amazing.
I mean, how do you not give that man your $39.99? I mean, Don West, absolutely epic. And honestly, he was one of my all-time favorite interviews. I am going to have to dig that out of the archives and play it for you guys sometime. Please. And let's all raise their hand if you've ever bought something from Don West. I mean, I will be the first to admit that I have, and I love the guy. I mean, that's just so awesome.
I had never seen that clip. And that's a really good one. That might be in the top three. That's great. Yeah. When I have a chance to look through the comments, we'll highlight a few if anybody can has stopped. Okay. Hold on. Let me get over there. That was great. In crime news, as reported by Sports Collectors Daily, police in Claremont, Florida are looking for a man who they say also had a big score. The suspect didn't pay a dime. Cops say he somehow got away with stealing nearly $3,000 worth of trading cards from a Walmart. The local police department's intelligence and analysis unit released photos of the man who they believe committed the heist back on March 18th around 6:40 p.m. The store on St. John's Lake Road is located west of Orlando. Investigators didn't exactly say which cards or card boxes were taken, but police are requesting that anyone with information about the theft or can help in identifying the suspect should call Crime Stoppers at 1-800-423-TIPS. Tips.
Oh, James, I don't know if I can. Yeah. I'm still trying not to laugh. And Grady Malachowski, how you've never heard of Don West, the original pitch man? Oh, awesome. All right, mark your calendars. National Hockey Card Day is back in just a couple of weeks, Saturday, April 13th, to be specific. Get a free pack of NHL trading cards at your local participating retailer, which you can find along with a checklist and image gallery at upperdeck.com/NHCD. And finally, it was so nice to see our old friend Chris Carlin come across our social feed this week because he was attending the MLB Soul Series on behalf of PSA and doing what he does best. Watch this.
This is a great video.
It's Chris. There is nothing I love more than sharing the hobby of card collecting with others. Today I'm here in Seoul, Korea. I thought we'd give away some cool cards to some of the fans in attendance. We've got Dodger cards, we've got Padre cards, and even got some golf cards because golf's a big deal here in Korea. So let's go see how it goes. I've got something cool. Do you like Otani? Here, this is for you. Korean TV, they love their Ha-Sung Kim. My man here, we've got a cool one for you.
Oh, look.
Yes, that's for you. This one's going to be fun. You are a big Otani fan,
right?
Okay. Here you go. You get to show Otani. That is for you. Oh. Card down. Card down. Let's go. I was thinking about sharing it with this baseball team back here, but I don't have enough cards.
What? Me?
Annyeonghaseyo.
Hi.
We have a gift for you. You like Ha-Sung Kim?
Oh, yeah. Oh, really? Thank you so much.
Are you sure? Woo! Go Padres! This is the cast man. He's a real big deal, and when you deliver beers to people, it's always nice to give them a little gift. You're a Dodger fan?
Yes.
Shohei Ohtani.
Oh, my God.
For you.
I'll take it. Go, Sandy! Go, Sandy! Go, 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 Sandy! Go, go,
who is the best third baseman in all of Major League Baseball? That's third baseman.
Manny Machado! Yes, you! Manny Machado! You! Manny Machado!
Are you sure?
Yes!
All right, we have a big celebrity we found outside here in Seoul, Korea. We're going to share a card with him. It's Shohei Ohtani. Shohei, we have a gift for you.
Oh,
your very own card.
Very premium card.
Yes, for you.
Presento.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Wow! Thank you!
And that is a look at this week's hobby happenings. I mean, nobody does it like Chris Carlin does. Nope.
He finds the best people, puts them on camera, and
so awesome. He looks like he had an absolute blast and brought the hobby right into people's hands out there in Seoul, South Korea. Fun. All right. Well, this evening we have, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4 box breaks, including two. We're going to start with two new releases. First up is one from Pieces of the Past Historical Premium Edition. We got a look at this one about a month ago, and they were kind enough to send us a box for release week as well. So I was going to say
it looked familiar.
Yes. You're getting 10 packs, 4 cards per pack, and 3 relics per box. So here we go. Oh, Don West. I almost want to play that again, just like on loop.
Yeah, that's a great clip. One of my favorites is him selling Beanie Babies. And name off all the names of the Beanie Babies. A really good book. Okay, so I've got a sell sheet here for us. 10 packs, 4 cards. Earning your relics. Hates. 3 of them, and then 1 or 2 number cards. There he is, LBJ. Hey, I like. Ooh, is that
George H.W. Bush, number to 25, his famous picture from Yale?
Yes. So that's one of the numbered cards. 1 to 2 of them. Okay.
William Fargo. You might recognize him from banking. Oh, these are some of the strongest packs I've ever encountered.
Ooh, really? Ouch.
Martin Van Buren. Abigail Adams, John's wife. Slick Willie.
There he is.
And the Civil Rights Act of 1964.
Oh, yeah.
This is the two products from Super Products. One of them we'll get to in our Hot in the Shop segment. It's an uber premium product.
Oh, yes.
Remember me having to pull away from the camera from time to time because the adhesive is so strong. I didn't want to whack the camera. Calvin Coolidge.
President.
John Marshall. John Jay.
Another number.
Signer of the Declaration of Independence. Number 45. And Flag the Barrel. Spanish-American War.
Oh, that's some nice art. Nice. These cards are, the quality is high. They look really nice. I bet they're good in hand as well.
Yes, they are. I mean, when you name a product.
Premium edition, yeah.
You better bring it.
Mm-hmm.
I have to talk to Scott Allen. He can save some money on an adhesive, I think. Willard Fillmore. George S. Patton. The man. Herbert Hoover. And if you've never seen the movie with George C. Scott of the same name, Patton.
Ah, yes.
Academy Award winning film and performance. Just an absolute epic. 13th Amendment. Very important milestone.
They're asking in the chat, what do we retweet? So tonight, because Chris isn't here to do individual tweets for everything, I pinned our broadcast. Remember when we used to do that? Retweet the broadcast, the pinned broadcast? So we're doing that tonight. So it is the pinned tweet. We're broadcasting live on Twitter.
So if you retweet that, you're in every prize draw.
Yep, he's going to draw just from that.
William McKinley. His monument is in Canton, just across the, stone's throw almost from the Football Hall of Fame.
Oh, wow.
It's one of the presidents that was assassinated. He has something in common. Every besides Reagan, every president that either suffered an assassination attempt, a legitimate attempt, or that was assassinated, they were going up against the central bank a little bit, which is interesting. John D. Rockefeller. Ooh, we got a numbered relic. Clara Barton, Red Cross, document numbered to 45. Beautiful card.
Yeah, really.
Beautiful card. And what I really like, look at that. There's the...
Oh, yeah, there it is. Yeah,
picture. And I've been talking to them about some... enhancements I think you're going to see on their products in the future. I can't really get into it right now.
Ooh.
Ooh, that one was easy. Okay, cool. James Garfield, another one. We got the dead presidents. Alexander Hamilton, Tricky Dick.
Hey.
And the Emancipation Proclamation. What do I see in there? What do I see in there?
Ooh.
All right, Calvin Coolidge. Winfield Scott Hancock, Thomas Edison.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Ooh,
there he is. William Tecumseh Sherman, who burned the path from Atlanta to the sea. Brutal. One of the total war generals of the absolutely horrific Civil War.
Can we see the back?
A lengthy,
okay, there it is. Lengthy, yeah, letter. I was going to say. That's a letter there. Fun. There we get. So one more to go when it comes to relic cards. And hey, there's a chance at a cut signature.
Chester Arthur. Patrick Henry. Give me liberty or give me death. Ronald Reagan.
Hey, Ronald Reagan.
And the Civil War. Oof. All right, two packs left. One of these should have another relic in it. Or maybe even a cut. How awesome would that be?
Oh, my gosh, yes.
Another Chester author.
Yeah.
You know, in all the years that I've been ripping packs, I've never, ever pulled a cut signature. Thomas Stonewall Jackson. Great general for the Confederacy, killed by friendly fire.
Hey.
George W. And the War of 1812. Super important event.
Oh, wow.
Not only proved that we could earn our freedom, but that we could keep it. Grover Cleveland. Jackie O. Beautiful picture.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Classy. And Mr. Fargo, and another general,
another Tecumseh
Sherman. All right, so we've got four winners tonight.
Right on.
Two numbered cards. I better Better write this down. So one winner will get the two numbered cards. And then we've got Clara Barton and then Tecumseh Sherman. So pieces, two numbered. Sherman one, Sherman two, and Clara. I like that Clara Barton card.
Yes, I think it's my favorite.
Yep.
Shiny, numbered.
Great picture.
Mm-hmm.
That's very cool. Yep. Nice product. Nice product.
Yeah, sharp.
In the past. Good looking stuff.
Mm.
All right, so that's tonight's history lesson. And make some room here because we got some more packs to open.
Yeah. Doctor Strange. 15 packs in this box.
Doctor Strange, Multiverse of Madness, with a not guaranteed an autograph. We do have some impressive luck with Marvel products, and we're going to need it because this does, as it even says right there, impressive list of talent autographs. It's deep. Elizabeth Olsen, Benedict Cumberbatch.
The gal that plays America.
Haley Atwell, yeah. So.
Oh, she's in it. That's right. Hold on. I've got the checklist up. Strange Sigs. And then there's Sorcerer Supreme Gold Parallel. Yeah, Haley Atwell. Benedict Cumberbatch. Benedict Wong, of course. He's a fantastic actor and in all the Marvels. And there's multiple versions of Benedict Cumberbatch autographs.
There's duels in here. How awesome would a Scarlet Witch, Doctor Strange auto be?
Rachel McAdams signed. Wow.
Yes. All right. I know that there's a lot of demonic stuff in this movie, and we start it right away.
Yeah,
their spirits use them.
Oh, wow.
I like the foil accents.
Yep. Yeah, these are nice. Wow.
Sheila Atom as Sarah. So that's an ensemble card, E15.
Okay.
Then we have America's Allies insert. There she is.
Oh, yeah. Scarlet Witch.
AA. And it looks like we're going to get a parallel in every pack. This is a red, as you can tell by the foil. Yeah, you were reading the synopsis, and I know you've seen it. I haven't seen this one, but this one was extremely much darker than the first.
Directed by Sam Raimi, the same guy who directed the Evil Dead films. So it has that kind of horror-y element to it, although I didn't find it to be too spooky, but there are some definite horrified elements to it, especially I'm thinking of one scene where I think it involves Scarlet Witch appearing
film as cell.
A zombie. Love those film cells. And I do not know how to pronounce her first name, but that's the America Chavez film cell. You get how many of those in a box? Are they guaranteed? That wasn't a Dream Plexi card. You get one per box.
Nice.
I like it.
I like it too.
Mm-hmm. Always a fun card.
Oh, the whole thing is plexiglass. Yeah, there's embedded cell. I get you. That's fun. Why they could do one per. Okay, cool.
Sure. That's neat.
I like it. I like it. And then first card, we got the red parallel of it.
That one. And then those That Wasn't a Dreams are tier from 1 to 4, numbered to 25. So I assume we got just the tier 1.
Numbered to 19.
Oh, hey. Well, that's 19
or number 19. Oh, I see what you're saying. Okay, yeah,
there are serial numbered versions.
Gotcha.
Yeah, wow, some of these pictures are amazing in the checklist here. These autographs.
Yeah, great border design. Kind of really.
It really, really looks nice, yeah.
Hey, one of these. Pure madness. We got Charlize Theron. Now, she's someone who did not sign.
No, and she shows up in a mid-credit scene, in just a one quick scene. And I think she's setting up the next film, the next, Doctor Strange's next adventure. So
what is a mid-credit?
So these Marvels, they do, once the film ends and the credits roll, there's the first part of the credits, and that's going to be set to music, and it will be animated and with a lot of colors and flashes, and it will have its own style, and it will go through all of the characters that you saw. And maybe some of the big names, the director, the producer, whatever.
Oh, it's, are you saying it's the first end credit part?
Yeah.
Like cut? Because then there's usually another one.
Yeah, because so then they show a scene, and then in this one they showed something. Doctor Strange did something in this one that set off. Ooh, that's a fun one, that lenticular. People are asking, what do we tweet? Tonight we're retweeting our pinned tweet, at GoGTSLive. You retweet the pinned tweet. It's just a broadcast of the show. That's retweet cool. That. Yeah, that looks really nice.
Are these one a box? Is this a hit?
That is it's a Dimensions.
Dimensional.
Dimensional. I'm going to need to bring up a is this a checklist or a do we not have the cell sheet, the PDF cell sheet on here?
Oh, you know what? This may be one of those products, Marvel products, where they solicited it without one.
Oh, sure. Fact,
yeah, that happens. So your guess is as good as ours in this case.
There's let's see, four lenticular cards. You get four lenticulars per case, I think is how I'm understanding that. So that's pretty good. Yeah. I like that.
Is there a doctor in the house? There is. There is.
Is that one numbered? There's a black version of the doctor in the house numbered to 15. Maybe that's just a regular one. Yeah, that might just be a regular one.
Red parallel.
Yeah.
So she's in the first
mid-credit scene. Yeah. And then after they do
I had just never heard that term mid. I always just referred to the whole thing as
end credit. Sure. Yeah. Well, now they do too. And like at the end of this one, I'm pretty sure the end credit scene after, before everybody leaves the movie theater, when you're done watching the movie is kind of a silly one that doesn't really tie to anything. It's got, that's a parallel. Bruce Campbell.
$199. Bruce Campbell?
Yes.
Interesting.
He has a scene. I think he's a hot dog vendor. He has a fun little scene.
I loved him in Burn Notice.
Sure.
Remember that TV show?
Yep. He's great. And a frequent collaborator with Sam Raimi.
And who was the woman in Burn Notice? Has she been in anything since? She was really good. I always thought she had a bigger career ahead of her, but I never really saw her anywhere else. But then I'm pretty out of Hollywood group, unlike I used to be. Gabriel Anwar, yes. Gabriella Anwar.
A lot of TV. Yeah, she
a lot of TV.
Things. Yeah.
Okay.
She was in Scent of a Woman. That's right.
Witchy woman. Ooh. Insert.
Ooh.
That's cool. And red parallel.
That did not look like a black number to 15 parallel of Witchy Woman. I have a feeling that'll stand out.
Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah. But the one that... so there's autograph versions of, or Pure Madness.
There's Rachel McAdams. James pointed out she did sign.
Yeah, that's fun.
Ooh.
I like that parallel. Wow.
That's number 50. 50. Look at that. That's beautiful. She is. Yeah, how do you pronounce an X when it's at the beginning? Do you pronounce it like a Z? Is it Jatil?
Somebody, Jatil? I wish if my girlfriend.
I know Hispanics, that's a Hispanic name, so yes. Someone maybe can help us out.
Yeah. I'm sure I've heard it spoken, and I'll be like, oh yeah, of course I've heard that. But right here in the moment, I am clueless.
Another witchy woman.
That's the very spooky sequence, I believe, when she's like kind of a zombie. It's pretty creepy and good. There she is. Yeah, perfect. That was a memorable sequence to me. For me. Jason Rocco. Social. Another.
Another funky parallel. One of 838. That's a unique number sequence.
Yeah.
First in the run.
That is fun.
Another ensemble card.
We had another parallel like that, right? From that style?
No, it was a different style. We had one number to 399, that's one to 838, and the one to 50.
838. That might be related to, because in this one they're jumping through multiverses, and is this a parallel?
Oh, is there Earth 838?
Yeah, there might be different. Yeah. Huh? Oh yeah, 838. So there must be. Yeah.
We got another first in the run, James.
Yeah,
I don't think we've ever had that before.
And I hope that's what they're doing for the first in the run on the parallel. They do the one of, and then everything else is just 2- and 3-. That's pretty cool. The one of reminds me of old 90s inserts, old basketball inserts. Yep, Earth 838. Thank you, High Pursuits. Appreciate it. I had a, and then they go to some Earth 6 something or Earth 616 and then 838. Okay, so that's fun. They're playing with the parallels and doing the same parallels and multiverses. There she is
again.
And she's some Marvel character. Again, when I got out of the theater, I was like, who's Charlie Saren's character? I don't know. I had to look it up. But she's apparently a very
James.
Stop.
One of 838s in the run. That's insane, dude.
Unless everyone is one of eight. They can't. They wouldn't do that, would they?
Right?
No. That's wild.
That's not their style.
No. Not at all.
That's foil stamped for sure.
Yeah.
Wow. That'd be crazy, dude. All right. Last pack.
All right. Yeah, those witchy woman cards, Melanie Paul's. Those are some fun ones.
All right. Sorry, guys. No auto fun rip nonetheless.
Ooh.
All right. So So yeah, we had those three are the same. And that one numbered to 50, beautiful. And that one to 199. And then we had the dimensional, the pure madness.
I think the dimensional was probably our rarest card that we hit. It says there's a, four lenticulars per case, and we didn't hit any portals cards.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I don't think so.
All right, two winners. I'm going to divide all this goodness up. Two winners are going to get four cards.
Nice. Those will be nice little bundles. And just to remind people, you're retweeting the pinned tweet at GoGTSLive on Twitter, X. Go retweet the pinned tweet. It's just a broadcast of the show. Here, let me go look and see how many people have retweeted it. StreamYard.
Okay.
Maybe you're doing the right thing, all 90 of you. Keep it up. And yep, I've seen we have a little view counter in the top. That has grown. People are checking in on Twitter. We're on to the football. Ooh, look at this.
All right. First of two back-to-back breaks from Panini, both on the gridiron. First up, new release from a couple weeks ago, Zenith NFL football. Two autographs, including one of them being a patch auto.
It's only a one-pack box, six cards. Two autographs, one base, two inserts, one rookie. We did pretty well in our rookies and stars box on our Twitch break yesterday.
Yeah, we did.
Getting that Dorian Thompson Robinson autograph. Wyatt Langford, first RBI. Whoops, this is Spectra. Sorry, folks. We're not opening Spectra. We're opening Zenith. I have those. Zenith. What are we reposting to win? Reamersma, our pinned tweet, and it's the show. It's a broadcast of the show. Here we go. Ooh, there's a patch.
Okay. Zach Ertz.
Ooh, that's shiny and fun.
Rookie Marte Mapu. Thunder and lightning. That's fun.
That's cool. And hey, it's Mahomes Kelsey. Pretty great duo to get. It's the duo you'd want. Super Bowl winners.
Class president.
Hey.
Saquon Barkley. I like that. Like people autographed it. That's cool.
Yeah, that is fun.
In the yearbook.
And hey, he's a new Eagle. That card kind of works because you can't really tell what jersey he's wearing. So if he wears 26 for the Eagles.
All right. First auto. It's numbered to 199. Huh. Ahmad Sauce Gardner.
That's nice.
Nice. That's awesome. One.
Yep.
High Point Signatures.
Cool.
Number to 199. Solid hit.
Yep, I like that a lot.
All right.
And here's the patch. It's a horizontal. I thought I saw red. Ooh, but now we're seeing a lot of blue. R-O. Marvin Mims. Hey, ooh.
Ooh, number to 50. That's nice.
That's nice. Yeah, that's really nice.
That's a solid hit right there. We're going to call that a boom. That's Marvin Mims, rookie patch auto. Beautiful patch pieces. Number 50.
Name and number, right?
Yep.
So number on the left side and the name on the right. Yeah. And hey, Marvin Mims, Denver, first season without Russell Wilson. We could be seeing kind of a second year jump if they get a quarterback that Sean Payton likes.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
I like it.
Cool. All right. Nice box of Zenith. So two winners.
Solid. Ooh, yeah. So you got to throw that Mahomes Kelsey in with something.
A prize pack eventually. I got enough to ship.
Somebody's going to get a great win in that prize pack because that's a. I think that's a solid little hit. These prize packs are no joke. They're good stuff.
But we're going to save that for some other prize pack.
Mm-hmm.
Gardner Mims. Okay. And
here it is.
Save the Big Daddy.
You're going to have a save lot of the ship Big out Daddy. Of this one. Ooh, yeah. Four packs, four cards per pack. You got four autograph cards, four memorabilia, so one of each in a pack, you'd think. Seven base or parallels, and one insert or insert parallel. Last year's box had some pretty low numbered parallels, if I recall. And they looked really cool.
I've been sitting on this box for a couple weeks.
Ooh.
We didn't have it when it was new. And I'm like, all right. Thick packs.
Oh, boy.
All right.
This is going to be a fun rip. Ooh-wee.
Give me my shades.
Oh, my. Yeah.
Jalen Carter, infrared, number 250.
Cool. Oh, wow.
That is spectacular. Spectacular.
Is that like kind of like, because I see his outline in like in the back behind him. Is that kind of like an oil paint or like an oil slick style? Yeah, that looks so cool. I bet that looks amazing in hand. Ugh.
It really does.
Yeah. Wow.
It really does.
Yeah. Wow. Hey, look at this. Super Bowl winner. Jerick
McKinnon. Number 299. These cards are just beautiful.
Yeah.
I mean, if you would have shown your 14-year-old self this kind of printing technology, you would have been like, what is that? Is that what kind of voodoo magic is that?
Yeah, wow.
How about some jumbo? Hey.
Go Vikes.
Swatches, Jordan Addison, rising rookie.
Yep.
And that's numbered to just 60. Nice.
Great card.
We've had this guy's auto before, if you can call it that.
Oh, hey.
Mr. Jalen Carter.
Ooh, and a purple
gives
pen.
Us a little something, but nice oversized patch there.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that'd be numbered to just 30.
Oh, my.
Wow. Nice. Oh, my. That was dang. That was one pack, James.
So that was our insert, that infrared. These inserts here, I need to go and look at the sell sheet now.
Rookie Bijan Robinson.
That's a good one. Good rookie to get. Hey, look at this fun Emmett Smith.
Yeah, some die cut loveliness.
Oh, I like that. Yeah, that's cool.
Numbered to 50.
Team color match, kind of. It's more of a turquoise.
We'll call it a complementing color.
Complementing color. That's cool. I like that one. That's fun. Opa Klingon style, you're retweeting the pinned tweet, which is just the show broadcast. We're since Chris isn't here to do multiple tweets.
Cedric Tillman.
Hey, nice big jumbo.
Oversize. I think that's Swatch. Rookie, number to 75.
Hey, nice.
Next up, we have a rookie autograph redemption of Devon A. Kane.
Hey, of the Dolphins.
Yep.
And he's the one who has the interest. I think it's A-Chan.
A-Chan.
I think, but then people were saying that, but then he said maybe it isn't. Somebody will know in the chat. I'm looking to see more about these inserts, and I might have to chase some of these inserts on the secondary market. On the third page of the sell sheet, they've got some cool ones: Ultraviolet, Neon Knights, Solar Eclipse. Hey, there's a Dolphin.
Tyreek Hill. ODB.
Ooh, is that a?
Looks like a. One of eight.
Eight.
One of eight.
It's neat. That's like a. It's not camo. It's.
It's kind of oil stainy.
Yeah. This is one where I wish they would have included that last page of the sell sheet with all those parallels.
Max Impact Luke Kuechly jersey. Hey,
that's fun. 60.
Yeah.
See, that was numbered to 8.
Tank Bigsby. Rising rookie, dual.
Ooh,
swatches, number 275. It's hard to pick up the 7 in there.
Neon splatter, I believe, is what to 8 is.
Oh, we'll call this a boom. How about this guy, Mr. Clay Matthews?
Super Bowl champion. Yeah, that's real nice. Nice and thick.
Numbered
too.
To just 25. Let's wow. Try to
find 25 on the checklist and see what that is. Yeah, that's nice. You'll take that. I guess I don't know what his Hall of Fame candidacy is, but he's definitely a Packer Hall of Famer. Fan favorite. Do they still have is there any Matthews in the league? That's all about Watts. It's a 25. Let's see if we can't find that 20. Oh. That wasn't neon pink.
Hey, we pulled an auto of this guy in our
Twitch. Hey, we sure did.
Dorian Thompson Robinson.
Slick.
How about Andre Iosavias? Numbered to 60.
Hey.
Josh Allen Brilliance jersey. And that's numbered to just 60.
Nice. The Clay Matthews is 25, right?
Yep.
It's a meta parallel.
And look at that patch. Quentin Johnston.
Yep.
Rookie patch auto.
That's nice. And
that's
numbered
260.
Wow. Wow. What a great, gosh, Spectre's a great rip every year.
It really, really is. All right, we had
my favorite.
We had four winners or four packs. I'm going to do four winners, and we're just basically going to divide this up as best as I can remember how they came out. You're basically going to get a pack. So,
oh, wow.
Everybody will get an auto.
Tremendous. And oh my gosh.
So four winners from that box as well. Well, that was a fun rip segment tonight,
yeah.
James.
Oh my gosh, just fantastic. Wow, wow, wow.
So we got Spectra 1 through 4. All right. Why don't you go ahead and why don't you update that poll question for us first? And no, yes.
Yeah,
go ahead.
I got it here. Poll question. We got it here. I'm gonna just bring it up so I can see it on this side. Hold on, my dog is poor buddy. He's just so hungry. What is your favorite, your must-have ballpark food when you go to a game in honor of opening day? Look at Peanuts jumping up. And hey, Peanuts is a really great treat.
It really is.
You get a beer, you get the Peanuts, and the best part about the Peanuts is you crack them and you just throw the shells on the ground. Ugh. That's right. I love doing that. They're at 11.2%, so they have grown, and they're actually in second place here. Cracker Jack popcorn in eight, with 8%. Hot dog 72%. It's a great. It's you love a hot dog at a game, and then local favorite at 8.8%. So good to see Peanuts jump into second place because hey, it's a wonderful treat at a ball game.
It really, really is. So fun question. If you haven't done so already, about an hour left in that. Okay, a couple video segments this evening, both courtesy of the Card Life. And this one, an email from a Card Life viewer sent the cast and crew on a mission to help and honor a fellow collector throughout the 2024 season. Watch this.
Mid-November, we received the following email through our website from a fan of the Card Life. My husband was an avid collector of sports cards. He just passed away, and I need help.
I'm Patty Copleen. I live in Bangor, Wisconsin. Mark was a science instructor for the middle school in New Lisbon, Wisconsin. He coached junior high wrestling and some junior high basketball, but his big love was high school football. And he was an athletic director for the last 25 plus years, probably. Mark was in a pretty significant car accident in 2015. It took about a year and a half of going routinely to the, they call it the TBI clinic, the traumatic brain injury clinic, that he was displaying Parkinsonian symptoms. They diagnosed Parkinson's in 2017, but I think what really pushed him over the edge was a severe heart attack this past July. I mean, he couldn't look at his cards. He'd fall asleep during sports on TV. So, you know, it was just kind of a rotten deal for him. I don't think he brought too many cards into the marriage because I think his mom threw a lot of them away when he went to school. But the culmination of collecting for 47 years that we have been married, wow. I hounded him way before this that he really, as they kept piling up, I said, what are you going to do with these things? Don't you think we should start trying to sell some of them? And he goes, well, no. I said, well, why not? I said, what are you going to use it for, the money that you get from them? Well, I like to help the girls with their wedding expenses. And if we have grandchildren, I'd, you know, like to have them have a little money to go to school. Well, now he's gone. I have all the cards. I have two unmarried girls and two grandsons. So that's how we left it. So yeah, that was what he wanted to do with them.
In honor of a fellow collector, we decided we would help Mark's vision and dream for his sports card collection come true. The great people at Rico provided this FI-8170 scanner to scan in Mark's collection. We'll be listing the cards for sale on our district page, district.net/thecardlifetv. Log on and take a look and see if there's any cards you might be interested in from Mark's collection.
Very cool. All right. James, you talked me into it. You know, those other four cards that were in Zenith, including Thunder and Lightning. Ooh, I wrote down Zenith Fun Lot.
Nice. So
another winner.
Fun lot is always the best lot. It really is. Okay, let me. We got to remove.
All right.
We're going to add.
So while you're getting that ready, in addition to the Pieces of the Past Premium and Marvel Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness, we have a handful of other new releases to tell you about in our Hot in the Shop segment. And we kick it off with the long-awaited release of Flawless NBA basketball cards. 8 autographs and 1 memorabilia card in every briefcase. 2 briefcases in a case. So top rookies from the 2022 NBA draft. Base cards are sequentially numbered to 20 or less and feature a genuine diamond embedded in the card. Every memorabilia swatch and flawless is game worn. Look for a stunning lineup of prime memorabilia autograph content, including flawless patch auto, star swatch signature, signature prime materials, and more. Monstrous one-of-one memorabilia cards and logo man autographs, laundry tag autos from top players in the NBA, and flawless delivers some of the best memorabilia autograph content of the year. Look for the new one-of-one insert scoring title. Checklist is up on GTS.net. Next up, we're going to stay on the NBA hardwood with an alternative SKU of Panini Prism. This one, Panini Prism Fast Break, 20 box case, 10 packs, 9 cards. You're getting an auto, 12 prisms, 6 inserts, and a rookie variation. This version is loaded with Fast Break exclusive content. That one auto, be sure to check out Fast Break exclusive autographs and Fast Break autographs and Fast Break rookie autographs. 12 prisms, including lots of exclusives, including blue number to 150, red number to 100, purple to 75, and so on. Plus, you get an exclusive rookie variation, plus 6 inserts, including the all-new inserts Kaleidoscope, Fractal, and Prism Break. Remember seeing some of those in our other box, so those aren't SKU specific, but the rookie variation aforementioned like that one is. That is up on the site on GoGTS.net with a complete checklist for that one as well. All right, from the hardwood to the gridiron, one of our favorite releases year in and year out, Obsidity 2023 Obsidian features 2 autograph cards, 2 memorabilia cards, plus 1 insert or insert parallel, and 2 base or 2 base parallel cards in every box. Look for the dark optichrome aesthetics and the funky futuristic inserts that we all know and love, that had become the calling card hallmark of Obsidian. Not a ton of new content in this release, but plenty of favorites, including SSPs like Black Color Blast, Vitrios, Velconics, and much more. This is in stores and breakers this week. And again, the checklist is up on GoGTS.net. Busy week for Panini America. From the hardwood to the diamond we go. Might remember this was one of Ivan's favorite products year in and year out. Panini Elite Extra Edition baseball cards, absolutely loaded with value. A 20 box case, 5 packs, 5 cards, 2 hits in every pack. You're getting 8 autograph cards and 2 memorabilia cards in every box. A staple of prospecting talent for years, Elite Extra Edition returns with a new crop of talent. Find the first memorabilia and autograph memorabilia cards of stars from the 2023 MLB draft. Find autos of some top baseball prospects, including Dylan Cruz, Paul Skenes, Jacob Wilson, Chase Dollander, and many more. And you guessed it, the checklist is up on GoGTS.net. All right, next up, we have a very unique product from Historic Autographs. Historic Autographs Retrograph 3, basically Series 3 of this product. This is a buyback all autographed baseball card product. You're getting six buyback autograph cards in every pack. Four boxes, 24 packs, six cards. The unit of sale is one 24 inner case. It's sold by the pack. So six cards per pack, all autograph, and find on average a Hall of Fame auto one in eight packs. So pretty good value here. I don't have the SRP available, but I know this isn't going to break the bank. And as you can see, they've loaded it up with some top tier talent on great cards. So this is in stores and breakers this week as well. I might have to window shop a break of that. Looks fun. All right, next up, we have a memorabilia product from TriStar, Hidden Treasures Autograph Football Mini Helmets. Case guarantees. So there's eight boxes in a case. You're getting four Hall of Famers, two football favorites, and two current players. Hall of Famers include Tom Brady, Peyton Manning, Joe Montana, John Elway, Roger Staubach, Barry Sanders, Deion Sanders, Bo Jackson, and many more. Plenty of current NFL stars like Mahomes, Josh Allen, Brock Purdy, CJ Stroud, and many more. Also, be sure to be on the hunt for those classic touchdown treasures. Randomly inserted tickets are redeemable for full-size autograph memorabilia. And then last but certainly not least, from our friends at Super Products, 2023 Keepsake Premium Edition. We had an opportunity to open the inaugural edition at the National, and very unique, super attractive product. You're getting five premium keepsake relic cards, one top tier brand hit, so that can be like Rolex, Ferrari, Bugatti, Pataki, Rolls Royce, Porsche. And then you're also going to get one jumbo 5x7 keepsake relic. We had an entire hood ornament off of a Ferrari. A car emblem or watch face dial card, a gem relic, and one additional card. Plus, every case, and there's only five boxes in a case, so a 20% chance, cut signature in every case. This product is absolutely loaded. Some of the historical figures include names like we mentioned in Bugatti, Ferrari, Patek Philippe, and many, many more, as well as well-known designers like Gucci, Chanel, Tiffany, historical figures like Abraham Lincoln, Ben Franklin, and many more. So this have a 20-category checklist for group breaking. So even if a box might be out of your price range, there will be breakers partaking of this. So 2023 Keepsake Premium Edition rounds out a look at what's hot in the shop this week. Oh, how'd I do?
You rocked it. You absolutely rocked it.
All right.
Good stuff. Good stuff this week.
Absolutely. All right. So time for me to pull the winners. And while I'm doing that, you guys are going to be watching another segment from Card Life TV. This one's a little bit, I should have played this probably a couple months ago, but I had it in the hopper for when there wasn't another clip to show you guys. So as you know, we're big fans of Card Life TV. We love the exposure that TV show gives to the hobby on, you know, regular TV. And so this is a clip of Best Of from the 2023 season. Watch this and we'll be back to announce 13 winners this evening. Lucky number 13.
At all these cards, I have over 100,000 cards, and I was just one day, I was like, what am I going to do with all these cards? And one of my friends that was collecting autographs, and I was like, I loved collecting autographs. Yeah. Why don't I do that again? So about 5 years ago, I started again. And now I try to send out about 10 a week.
Okay. How many autographs through the mail have you gotten, roughly?
A couple thousand, easily a couple thousand. Yeah, I've done all four major sports, as well as a bunch of celebrities as well. This card's very, very special to me. When I was 7 years old, my dad bought me my first pack of baseball cards, brought a pack home for me, and I remember sitting at the kitchen table, opened the pack with him. And this is like the fourth or fifth card in the pack. This exact card,
Not a replaced card, the actual card opened by you.
I've had it all these years, and I always cherished it. And I don't know what came over me one day. I said, I'm going to get it signed, because I saw somebody with had one of them signed. And I said, I'm going to get them signed, because I really love TTM. And I think it'd be great to have them in the collection and pass it on to my kids.
Right.
So I sent it off to Cecil Cooper in Texas first, and he signed it pretty quickly. And then I sent to Mike Garman, who I loved as a pitcher. Yeah. I always loved him as a pitcher. I'm so bumming when he got traded. And he was a really quick turnaround, maybe like a week. So I got them both them signed, and then said, we'll send it down to Colin Fiske's in Florida. He collects money for cancer, so I don't mind giving a donation.
Right.
And he signed it, and then it came back, and I was just so thrilled.
The legendary Z-Nut card set. This is the longest consecutively annually issued card set in existence for the minor leagues, 1911 to 1938. But perhaps the most noteworthy is the card of Jimmy Claxton. And he was the first black ball player to appear on an American baseball card. He signed a contract under the guise of having Native American heritage. And when it was discovered that he was African-American, along with Native and otherwise, he was unceremoniously let go. He pitched in two games. And the photographer for the Collins McCarthy Candy Company happened to be at the ballpark one of those days and took his photograph.
I watched Butker kick the go-ahead field goal. And ever since, I've been collecting cards. I discovered that he was Catholic, and I go to a Catholic school, and it's kind of cool to know that Butker's also Catholic. So I started this group of them about a year ago-ish, and my newest card that I just got was the gold out of 10.
On the trading card database website, Parker ranks number one in the number of unique cards of Butker.
I'm in first with around like 120 some cards.
What reaction does he get when he tells people who he PCs?
They're just kind of like, you collect a kicker?
One of my friends at the office, a big Boston Bruin fan, had a big 2x3 poster. It was just hockey cards in the frame of Cam Neely. They didn't make a design or anything, but it was so much fun to just look at all the cards and the stats. And so I was like, what if we did a mosaic with the hockey card? So I don't collect cards, so I started buying Lemieux cards for that purpose. Maybe 800 Mario Lemieux cards, and made my first one out of 260 cards, just to try to see to do it, like, can I do it? And I put it on eBay, and my mom was the highest bidder. So it was never, I mean, it's a giant 4x6 thing. I did two more with real cards. There's one here on the wall that's not in a frame or anything, just stuck on the wall. And then the mosaic at like the little store in Joliet down here with Pokemon cards. They had a wall, and I walked in there, and I'm like, do you mind if I make, like, I show them what I do? And the guy was all excited, and just with the excitement, it was awesome. So I made an 800 Pokemon cards with real cards for their store. And I love the fact that it's in public, and I can just sit there and watch people. It blows their mind. And I for me, this is like eating caviar or something. I just know it's just fun to see that moment where, like, their mind just blows. And then a little bit later, I realized I don't even have to have the cards. I mean, there's image of cards all over the internet. I just have to find them, make them in a collection, and then use that. There are times I was wondering, is this the best use of my time? And every time I go back to that moment that I see people and that I have sometimes when I make this, and I'm like, that's worth it. Like, if I have a talent to be able to create something that makes that moment for people, then that would be silly not to do that. It's really fun.
The jokes write themselves. I mean, you relieve yourself, and it's a shrine to relief pitchers. I mean, the potty humor, the sophomoric humor in me, is it just bubbles out. You can't help it. There's, you know, signed balls. This is the championship wall. You only get on this wall when you win a championship with the Phils. I'm an optimist, which is I feel like we're gonna fill this in my lifetime. But as of right now, I'm keeping them small on purpose so that I can fill this up as we win and win and win and win.
Let's go.
I put it on Twitter, and before you know it, former ball players are talking to me, and you know, guys that are like, wait a minute, you have my picture where? And there was only so many guys that have ever made it to the major leagues. 20-some thousand, ever. And to be one of those guys that made it, like, that's just super cool to be able to celebrate them and honor them. It's just, one, it's another part of fandom, but two, like, they should be honored. They made it. They made it to the peak, and that's awesome.
We're back.
Good stuff. All right. I finished just in time.
Awesome.
Have to do great everything. Timing. Whew. Okay. 13 winners tonight. What you're going to do if you hear your name called, you're going to email the show. GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. You're going to include your full name, your X handle, your mailing address, and what you won. All right. That's all scrolling for you at the bottom of the screen. So here we go. I'm not going to show the card just because I need to pay attention to what I'm doing here.
Yeah.
All right. So first up, we had the two numbered cards from Pieces of the Past Historical Premium Edition. That's going to @JerryGross123. Then we had William Tecumseh Sherman relic number one. That goes to Robo Man Can 1987. Robo Man Can 1987. And then Tecumseh Sherman number two goes to Hobo Matt. Hobo Matt. And then the Clara Barton relic, really nice card, yeah. Number 35, if I remember correctly, goes to Crafty Graph @CraftyGraph. All right, Dr. Strange, two winners, two lot winners. So lot number one is going to go to @JFranklin2678. @JFranklin2678. Dr. Strange number two goes to Musical Mel 72. Musical Mel 72. All right, the Sauce Gardner auto goes to, from Zenith, goes to Ben's Wild Pitch, @Ben's nice. Wild Pitch. All right, the Marvin Mims auto goes to 49er Gunner. 49er Gunner. That's 49ER Gunner. It's the Marvin Mims. And then that Zenith remaining lot, all the other cards, goes to @RickMastFan67. @RickMastFan67. All right. Then we have the first of our four Spectra winners. Spectra lot one is @M Balsley. Spectra number two is @NY_loves_DDub. @NY_loves_DDub. Spectra lot two. Spectra lot three goes to Kebo 629, KEBO 629, and that must mean that our last and final Spectra lot and prize of the night goes to soccer_lover_18. You are lucky winner number 13. All right. That is going to do it for all of us here at Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Lord willing, we'll do it all over again next week. Week to week, I'm in limbo, so we'll just kind of have to play it by ear, but I'll be planning on it and canceling if need be. But let's plan and think positive thoughts that we'll be back next week, same time, same bat channel, with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Thank you very much to James Gale for sitting in for Chris Stuber and doing double duty this evening. And thank you to Scott Allen at Super Products, Paul at Upper Deck, Scotty at Panini America for letting us take a look at some fantastic product tonight. Yeah, we will see you next week, but in the meantime, you know what to be doing. Always be collecting. Have a great night and a good weekend, everybody. Good night.